By 2035, autonomous driving could create $300 to $400 billion in revenue. Now, that's according to the MBAs over at McKinsey. And when we look at what NVIDIA is doing these days in revenue, so last quarter they had $22.1 billion. That's around $88.4 billion annualized. So if they were able to capture, let's say, a quarter of the autonomous driving opportunity, that could certainly be the next big thing for NVIDIA and reduce their reliance on the growth of data center revenues. Now, when we look at NVIDIA's revenues over time, that green arrow on the chart here, please ignore the fiscal mess that's on display, but the points are still valid. So the green arrow points to around when we invested in NVIDIA, and over the years, we've just been closely watching their growth. So you could see this piece we did in 2023 after they had a stalled year of growth. We said NVIDIA's growth is stalling, why we're not worried. And then in 2024, there's certainly nothing to be worried about right now. What we're most concerned with is inevitably when the AI hype dies down and all the investments in data centers are coming to maturity, and there's going to be some sort of baseline for data center growth. And that's when we're going to look to the other segments that NVIDIA has for future growth. And one such segment would be NVIDIA DRIVE. So they hope to capture that massive autonomous driving opportunity that the McKinsey MBAs pointed out. Now, when we think about the autonomous driving thesis, it really needs no introduction. So on the hardware side, you have LiDAR. There was a lot of LiDAR SPACs that fizzled out. You have computer vision. Mobileye is the leader in computer vision right now. And you have auto manufacturers thinking about offering autonomy as a service, such as Tesla. You have autonomous cars used for ride sharing. So think about how autonomy might impact Uber's margins. Then you have rich data sets, such as what Tesla has accumulated over time. And Tesla's robo-taxi thesis is a large part of ARK's bullish views on Tesla. So you can see here Musk himself saying the reason Tesla is making rapid progress is because we have vastly more data and this is increasing exponentially. So all those Teslas you see out there on the road, they're all gathering data. And this chart on the right here, this was taken from ARK Invest. So by 2027, they're expecting that 44% of Tesla's revenues will come from robo-taxi, and 64% of EBITDA, the profits from Tesla, will come from robo-taxi, electric vehicles being less than half of Tesla's business. Now, there's certainly some regulatory concerns we'd have there around how Tesla might be able to operate robo-taxis given their relationship with the current administration. But when we think about the autonomy thesis, there's certainly some knock-on effects that are worth mentioning. So you have the car insurance industry. There's a less likelihood that autonomous vehicles will have an accident, so it should become cheaper to insure everything. The auto insurance industry should take a hit. Car usage. So everyone goes out and buys a car, and then it sits there 95% of the time not being used. But what if your car could run errands for you or for other people even? What if your car spent its spare time working for Uber? Now, speaking of Uber, generally drivers keep 75% of the fare for any given ride. So if Uber gets into autonomy, they'll be able to capture all that extra revenue. This is on a side note, fewer organs. So currently 15 to 20% of organ donations come from highway fatalities. So that's quite interesting. Can you think of any knock-on effects not mentioned here? Put those in the comment section, please. It's an interesting topic. Now, let's get into talking about NVIDIA's auto segment. The chart on the left shows you just how small it is. So you see the dark blue bars, and there's a little light blue icing on top. That light blue icing reflects their automotive revenues. The dark blue, of course, is data center. On the right, we've broken those out. This is from Main Street Data. They do a good job of providing such information. The hardware opportunity for NVIDIA offers near-term upside but the software and automotive opportunity are expected to drive the next leg of growth after they achieve scale. That's according to Spear, a company we're going to talk about today that does analysis on various disruptive technologies. So this chart here shows quarterly growth of that segment. We're going to look at annual because it depicts growth a bit better. But when we look at the NVIDIA DRIVE ecosystem, here you can see various stakeholders. So you have tier ones like Foxconn and Bosch. There's the robotaxi element. You have car and truck makers. You see that they've sidled up with BYD, Hyundai, Volvo, other names on there. And then on the right, you see sensor models, simulation, AV software, etc. So what's interesting to note on this slide is that NVIDIA's pipeline, so they talk about this $14 billion design win pipeline. We don't pay much attention to things like that. But what's interesting here is to see that in 2023, they signed an awful lot of Chinese automakers. Now, when we look at the segment, the auto segment for NVIDIA and the yearly results, this is what it looks like annually, all right? So last year they saw 21% growth, before that 60% growth, and we went into the 10Ks and pulled out the verbiage, and you can see it's all about growth in self-driving platforms, sales of self-driving solutions, revenues up due to self-driving. So that's certainly what their auto segment is all about, although there's other components of that as well. Now, before we get into that further, I wanted to have a bit of a public service announcement. So as our regular readers and subscribers know, we keep a Romanian fortune teller on staff. She helps provide alpha in much the same way that any other fund manager employs techniques like technical analysis. She conducted a recent psychic audit and found that some of you have watched multiple videos of ours and you're not subscribed to the channel. So right now we're using the carrot, you know, subscribe to our channel, become a better investor. But eventually she wants to use the stick, which I'm told could even include some long-term alpha erosion. So the best way to stay on the right side of a feisty Romanian card reader is to just click the subscribe button. And do it now, please. You'll never have to worry again. Now, in my first job, I learned about leveraging. And then when I did my MBA, I learned that leveraging is pretty much all you should do. And that's the act of using someone else's hard work, giving them as little credit for it as possible. Now, I dislike that idea. I want to make sure that this firm, they have a disruptive technology ETF, a lot less known than ARK, but some of the research is quite impressive. The firm is called Spear. And they did this piece that's worth a read. It's NVIDIA, the one-stop AI shop. And in that piece, they talked about what NVIDIA is up to in the automotive space. And they say here, outside of Tesla, which is developing its in-house autonomous driving system, as we all know, NVIDIA is likely to power most other OEM systems. Okay, that's quite a bold claim. We're going to touch on that a little bit. They talk here about the company having $11 billion in automotive backlog, which it expects to convert over 6 years. That's about $1.8 billion a year versus the $1 billion last year that NVIDIA's auto segment brought in. So we should expect that segment to grow. Here's an interesting statement. Mercedes alone expects to generate $2 billion in revenues from car subscription services by next year, and high single-digit billions by the end of the decade. Now, Mercedes has a partnership with NVIDIA where profits are split 50-50. That's an interesting model. So can we assume these 50-50 partnerships are typical across the board? If so, then NVIDIA is going to be relying heavily on the propensity for drivers to subscribe to these autonomous driving capabilities. Now, this will represent the much-needed recurring revenue streams that NVIDIA has openly said they're pursuing. And when we look at the automotive segment today, it represents a small amount of money, but could, as Spear says, become a growth driver and margin accretive once it reaches scale. Now, Spear then goes on to talk about the various components of NVIDIA DRIVE, first being vehicle hardware. SoC stands for system on a chip. So NVIDIA's DRIVE Orin is currently used by 25 out of 30 major vehicle manufacturers, including all major Chinese EV producers. You know, Spear estimates the content per vehicle to be around $300, so implying a 50% penetration. They say that's somewhere around a $15 billion annual opportunity. If we look beyond just hardware, we go into software and hardware, then there's Hyperion. That's an end-to-end platform connecting cameras, sensors, radars, and LiDAR. And Hyperion 9, expected in 2026, will feature 14 cameras, 9 radars, 1 LiDAR, and 12 ultrasonic sensors. Investors in Mobileye will be eyeballing this because it sounds an awful lot like the solutions in our Mobileye presentation that we looked at that they're developing. They want to go away from just providing those hardware components to something more holistic. Then they talk about supercomputer model training, where Drive Orange serves as the brain, Hyperion is the nervous system, and model training occurs outside of the car and is yet another opportunity for NVIDIA. So these are three areas where NVIDIA can make money in auto. And when we look at the platform that they have, so we referred to Drive Orin, right? And that's reflected here. Well, the new platform is going to use the Thor Superchip. And this is where things start to come together. NVIDIA unveils Drive Thor, a centralized car computer unifying cluster, which covers infotainment, automated driving, and parking in a single cost-saving system. This was back in 2022. They talked then about how Zeekr was their first customer. We just recently, I think just days ago, did a video on Zeekr that's worth a watch. When you look at NVIDIA Drive Thor, their centralized computer, you can see here it says functionally safe platform for advanced driver assistance and in-vehicle infotainment integration. The idea here is that you don't have to have computers for all these different components of what a car needs. You just buy this single solution from NVIDIA, and it covers all that at a lower cost. Now, we did a piece on Mobileye, and you can go to our website, search for Mobileye, and pull that up. And we talked about the competition, the most formidable competitors for Mobileye, and two names mentioned, Qualcomm and NVIDIA. We haven't gotten into Qualcomm very much, but here you can see NVIDIA's revenues and how they're going to be competing against both those companies in their auto segment. So it's not a blue ocean TAM. ADAS, by definition, is, but there's some very formidable competitors they're going to have to fight. Now, one problem for NVIDIA, let's say a current and potential problem, would be the limitations that have been put in place by the U.S. government for chip makers when it comes to China. So you can see here in the third quarter of fiscal year 2023, the U.S. government put in place restrictions or certain licensing requirements for key hardware coming from NVIDIA. Now, when you look at their revenues from China, so that's probably the most obvious problem when it comes to these this group of countries that the U.S. government is putting restrictions on. You can see that NVIDIA's still growing revenues to China. So whilst data center might be a lesser part of those revenues, they're still able to pursue growth. But there's a concern there because the way that they look at this is based on hardware components and also performance. So if NVIDIA is building out this Thor system and it's deemed to be too powerful, is that going to put a damper on the relationships they've been building, especially last year with all those Chinese EV makers? I don't know, but President Biden's new tariffs potentially could piss off the Chinese government. So it's said, and you'll see this video on the day when this is supposed to happen, that tariffs on EVs could quadruple from 25% to 100%. And there's a risk that these tariffs could lead to a broader trade conflict. And Shoeless Joe 428 from our YouTube channel asks a very good question here. He says, do you think the Chinese government will respond in kind against Tesla in China? Well, let's certainly hope they don't, because China accounts for around 22% of Tesla's 2023 revenues. For NVIDIA, it's certainly a lot less than that. But their heavy focus on Chinese automakers is a potential threat to the growth of their auto segment. So Just some concluding thoughts here. As we said earlier, autonomous driving represents a $300 to $400 billion opportunity, and NVIDIA is getting into bed with lots of Chinese automakers. Now, that's a double-edged sword. The growth of Chinese automakers is nothing short of astounding, so it's great to see some exposure there. But on the same token, the geopolitical tensions create a problem. Now, when data centers eventually stabilize, growth for NVIDIA is going to need to come from other areas of the business, particularly recurring revenues like the revenue sharing model they have with Mercedes. Those are the most attractive. Now, the stated backlog of the company means we should see strong growth coming from automotive, but that remains to be seen. Just remember, revenue growth is the ultimate ground truth always. Now, some people may be wondering if NVIDIA is overvalued. Well, that certainly depends. You can always torture the data and make it say anything you want. I put up another video here that touches on that topic. It's quite good. Before you watch that, please make sure to subscribe to our channel, support our work. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this today.